Hello everyone in MedicalScribe. I'm Karar Haider, student at Baghdad Medical College. Today we will talk about the skin functions. In the previous video, we talked about the hair structure with its two major parts, the hair shaft and the hair follicle. And we talked almost all details about these parts. In this video, we will talk about the hair functions. As we know, the hair in the human body exists almost in all regions, with a different degree of thickness, except some regions will be devoid of hair, such as the lips, the palms of the hand, and the soles of the feet. These regions will have no hair. So the hair in the other regions will have six main functions. Firstly, the thermal regulation. The hair helps in regulating body temperature. So if the body was cold, the arrector pili muscle, which attached to the hair follicle, will contract. So the hair will stand up. As a result, the hair in this region will erect, which will insulate heat by making heat trapping layer above the epidermis. So the body become warmer because of this layer. In contrast, in the hot temperatures, the sweaty glands will secrete sweat that evaporate to cool down the body. So the arrector muscles relax and the hair will lie flat on the skin. So this heated rubbing layer disappears, and the body cooled down. This is regarding the thermal regulation function. The second function is that the hair will protect our body from four main things. A, it will protect the body from ultraviolet radiation that harm the skin. B, the hair in the scalp will play an important role in preventing direct trauma to the skull. C, the hair will protect the regions that wrap together, such as the armpit. D, the hair will be considered as a barrier that protects the body from foreign substances, such as the nostrils hair, which will help in keeping dust and foreign matter out. The third function is the sensation. So when someone touches us or air comes to vibrate our hair, these vibrations will be received by the sensory receptors in the hair follicles and in the skin. As a result, it will make us feel that this region touched by someone, or the air stream comes from that direction. The fourth function is to identify persons. So if we get a proper sample from the hair of an unknown dead person, we can use this sample in identifying him and use it in the forensic analysis that give us a lot of information. The fifth function is the psychosocial health. The hairstyle and the way that we take care of our hair and beard will give us a specific social impression and may be considered a symbol of beauty and health. So in general, the hair can give us an idea about the psychosocial well-being of the individual. Lastly, regarding the hair functions, and in specific, the eyebrows and the eyelashes, they have an important function, which is in addition to their function to protect the eye from dust and foreign materials, they will play a key role in the non-verbal communication. So we can display our emotions, like if we're sad, or if we're angry, or surprising, and other emotions, which is a very important thing in the social communication. And we can display them by our hair. So these were almost everything about the hair functions. And that's it. I hope what I said makes sense. See you next video, and goodbye.